Hi, and good afternoon, good morning to all of you. Myself, Kinjal Vora, I am a marketing head at Drona HQ, and I would like to extend a warm welcome to each of you, our dynamic divas out here on this Women's Day, to come and share with us a journey that you have been through in the technology industry. Thank you for gracefully accepting my invitation and, you know, come here and share with all the young women who are out there who aim and plan to have a career in tech. So looking forward to hear from all of you. I'm very excited to hear you and can't wait to introduce our guest to the audience today. We have a very fantastic panel and a very widespread, diverse panel today with us. And let me start with Shruti. Shruti has been, hi Shruti.
Hi there.
Shruti is a leading woman in tech and has experience of over 15 years across business and technology, marketing, sales, product management, and also entrepreneurship. Today, along with being a mother of two preschoolers, Shruti bridges as a product manager between technical and business teams at CleverTap, a SaaS-based platform. She has been a senior product manager at Barnes & Noble Education for more than 4 years. Shruti also co-founded Vista Solutions during her time at ISB and headed marketing and sales for the company, where she vocalized the concept of learning through simulation. Her diverse experience in industry makes her a true woman leader in technology. Shruti did her post-graduation from ISB with dual major marketing and strategy and holds a bachelor's degree in IT. Hi, Shruti. Tell us something interesting and start with something that we do not know about you.
That's such a fantastic introduction already. I'm already on cloud nine. Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be here on Women's Day. I love being here. Thing that doesn't come out in my LinkedIn profile is that I love to write for children. And I have a YouTube channel with my son. We just have fun. And we put content out there for kids. And that's something I'm very passionate about and I enjoy doing.
Fantastic. Looking forward to more such content from you, Shruti.
Absolutely.
A very vast experience with you as well. You have moved into from a tech role, done your master's, and again moved to an entrepreneurial role, and then product management, a role which is like a bridge between a technology and the marketing team, a juggle. What is your journey like? Do share some insights from your journey.
I think this the beginning is very similar for all of us. So I'm also an engineer. I was also mass recruited into Syntel, and then I went to TCS. From there, so I spent similar to all of, quite a few of you here actually spent about 3 years in that services. I was also in COBOL, and from there I went to ISB for my MBA. Did the year there in ISB. I started up actually with a partner, and I was clear that I wanted to start up in ISB. So I did that for about a year. We did simulations. This was basically while we were at ISB, we saw that simulations were a great way to learn, especially very like concepts that most people found dry, like op simulations, right? So things that were hard to learn just by the book. So we started that, and unfortunately that didn't go very well for me. So about a year down the line, I quit the startup, and I joined this corporate strategy, CEO's office kind of role at CMS, which is like an Indian conglomerate. I spent about, I think, 3 years there in the CEO's office, working on different strategic initiatives. Like there was some really, there was a printing division at CMS. So I'd be doing costing and pricing sort of scenario analysis for them. And then I did resource management. I built up a resource management team there. It was very, very different pockets of projects because it was like the CEO's office. So that was really interesting. And with that resource management sort of stint, I realized that I do like designing systems and figuring out what should go into systems. So very strangely, that sort of started my journey into product management. And I got into an edtech role with an Indian startup called LoudCloud, which got acquired by Barnes & Noble. So that was my real first product management role. Did that for about 4.5 years. And after that, now for the last 2 odd years, I've been in CleverTap, again in product management. So broadly B2B product management experience. So that's been now about 6+ years of product experience right now. So very quickly, that's wrapping up my experience.
Interesting. A very quick and a crisp experience that you have shared with us. Do you have a mentor? Or are you a mentor?
Specifically, do I have a mentor? Not like one person. The range of resources and people and everything. From family. It could be someone in your family who you look up to. For me, it was also my dad, who was an entrepreneur, first generation entrepreneur. So it started with him. Like someone to look up to, someone whose ideals were something that were hard to achieve, someone who, you know, went against the grain of the community then to go, like long time ago, it was like 40 years ago, to start out. Right? Starting up was not what it is today then. And without the safety nets that we have today. So it's not the capital and, you know, the job market and all of that was not as comfortable as it is today in that age. So definitely my dad has been a mentor for me. And then after now with social media, I think it's quite easy, like with LinkedIn and Twitter and everything, to find the right things to resonate with. And then it sort of follows you, right? Like you like something and it follows you. I think it's a mixture of everything.
Yeah. So my question to you, Shruti, what it takes to be an effective leader?
So I think it totally depends on your style, on the situation, what it demands. So I was just reading this book, and it say there are a lot of theories on it, right? So one of them said that there are two types of leaders, right? So people love to like divide the world up like all binary, but yeah, so this book said that two types of leaders who are who like to be strategic, and leaders who like to be implementers, right? So then there was another thing which divided up the world as leaders who like to take decisions up front, youth leaders who are collaborative. There's so many different theories and so many well-written books and well-established, you know, things out there. But I think it's just up to you. It's totally up to you. So my personal style is very collaborative. I like to take everybody along, and I like to say we did it. I've also seen people who are equally good at the job, who like to say that this is me, this is on me, we'll go ahead and we'll do this. But I think the most important thing is to own your decision, take people along and move forward, and see that you're going ahead, right? Have a vision, work towards it, move forward. It does not, and take everybody along, be transparent. And own up. If it didn't happen, it didn't happen. It's fine. Like it's very important to be yourself, be true to yourself, know who you are. Like some of the others here have said, truly be self-aware what your style is. Make that work for you. Be authentic and move forward.
Right.
Totally depends on you.
Yeah. What aspects of product management do you find most exciting and the least?
All right, so that's a really good question, right? So let me think about it. So I think there are a few things that really get me going about product management. So I love the early blank canvas days of anything, right? It could be a product, it could be a feature, it could be just a bug or an issue. So at that point, I love discovering more about the problem. I love brainstorming it with folks across teams. Say it could be design, it could be engineering, it could be the QA folks on your team. I love getting into these meetings, right? They're my favorite. I can almost feel some of the audience who are going to watch this cringing, right? I knew it. PMs love meetings, right? Well, then, that is true. But moving on, I also confess that I love some of the more boring bits of product management as well. Like, for example, so many years on as well, I still love writing the spec, right? So that's like things which I love doing. What I love the least, right? And which are the interrupts. Like the deviations from the plan for the quarter, the sprint. I've learned over time that these are inevitable, and it is at times at the cost, you know, it comes like this is something that happens at the cost of the agility that the startups must have, they must possess in order to sprint forward. So that's like some of the good and the bad. I can see Seema smiling and like, I get that.
Did you come across any scenario which required you to say a no to a project or an idea?
I'm a product girl, Kinzel. That's part of the JD. but honestly, yes, saying no is a big part of a PM's job. Every quarter, every sprint, you have limited bandwidth. And it's not just the small projects you say no to, right, of which there are many, but also big, meaty features which you know will make an impact. But as in any, yep, you have to, but as in any good decision-making process, I've learned quite the hard way. It's good to have a framework. Not that I've made an absolute science of it. It's not like I put something into an Excel sheet and it spits out. Yeah, I think frameworks help you think. And they help you think through it consistently. So you go back to it and that is what you thought the previous time as well. And it also helps you communicate this decision better to stakeholders. And we know there are many of those as well. So it just helps you think through well. So I think pretty much you've got to say no, but you've got to say no in a consistent way.
That's from the product manager. Say no in a consistent way. Shruti, what new opportunities do you see lying ahead for more women who get involved in technical roles?
Adding to some things that people have said, right? The opportunities are there for everybody. But we need to, it's more fundamental, I think. It's not just giving opportunities at an org level or at a society level. All of that is very important. But I really like the concept that Sheryl Sandberg talks about in Lean In, where she says there is a leadership ambition gap, right? Where she says that from the beginning, the boys and the girls are conditioned differently, right? She says that from the beginning, women are told, directly or indirectly, right, that someday you will have kids, someday you will get married, and that someday you will have to, you know, do that. Right? So from the beginning, the ambition for a career is very skewed towards boys as compared to girls. I think the opportunities are there, like the tech industry is waiting to bloom and flourish. And that is there for a boy or a girl, right? But how we raise our children, right? That I think that's where we begin as a society, as a whole society, right? Two parents raising a child is a different thing, but as a whole society, we need to raise our girls and boys better to know that everybody contributes to everything in society, right? So if I think we have to handle it at that level, and then the opportunities are ripe for the taking.
Right. On that concluding note, what we agree, technology isn't scary. We all started with being a programmer or a non-programmer, software engineer, developer, and we have evolved into a business, into a leadership roles, or into roles where we are enabling businesses and solving day-to-day problems with technology. Being a woman in tech do not have to be confined by those definitions or profiles of technology. You can grow, evolve, and learn from the business aspect as well. To have a successful and satisfying career, I think the prerequisites are eagerness to solve problems and have a confident headspace. Just pick up those opportunities, try and gain things, pull up your socks, do your decisions every day, have the grit to follow it. And knowing the critical business pain areas and solving it with computational thinking are the just key elements that will help women have their journey through a tech industry or a tech career. And that's exactly the message that Drona HQ is giving: coding or no coding, achieve digital solutions for your organization at speed. I think that's the end of, I'll wrap it up, end of a wonderful panel. I think we took way too much time for your discussion, and I would love to thank you once again for coming up, sharing your experiences, sharing your profound knowledge that you have gained over years. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kinjal, for inviting me, and it's been wonderful spending time on a Saturday afternoon with all of you. Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
Thank you so much. Yeah, same here. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Kinjal. I think this gave us an opportunity to connect to these wonderful ladies, and we'll definitely
absolutely
relish this connection. Like, knowing each other, spending this 1.5 hour was